Hi. In this quick tip, we're going to talk about compound paths. Or maybe it will be a longer tip. So let's see, let's dive in. When you create compound paths, then you have mostly some shapes, and then you select them both and go to Object, Compound Path, Make, and then you get a hole. Most of the time this works and Illustrator just creates the correct thing. Let's get to something more complicated. I'm going to keep this. So let's make some text. And sorry, this is ugly, but let's keep it. So I'm going to create outlines of this and then going to Object, Path, and Offset Path, like so. And I have offset this, and this is now selected, so let's just take the opportunity and go to Pathfinder and unite all these shapes. So we've got this outline, and let's take a look at how this looks in the layers panel. So it's all grouped. Let's just ungroup this like so. And now I want to punch out the smaller type from the larger expanded version. So let's select that all. And first, what I need to do is going to find out that smaller one in here. It's that one. No, that one is the expanded one. So let's deselect it. And now only the smaller one is selected. So I'm going to unite that as well. And you see, we've got two groups in here. And of course, that smaller one needs to be in front. So let's color it differently so we can actually see it like so. And now I want to subtract it from the other one. So, and for doing that, as we have already seen, I'm going to Object, Compound Path, Make, like so. Well, this doesn't work. And let's find out why. So you see the shapes are there, but they are just not punched out from that larger one. Why does that happen? So let's go to Window Attributes. And in the attributes, I'm going to show the overprint only. So this is the default view of the attributes panel. There you don't see it. You need to show all. And there we have two buttons. Those are the fill rules. And by default, they are set to this one. Use non-zero winding rule. That's kind of complicated, actually. And already, if you set it to the other one, then you have fixed this. Sometimes you need this one. So in some rare cases, it's actually quite important to have that one. And how does it even work? So that one takes into account the direction of the path. So let's select this M here. And let's go to Object, Path, and reverse that stroke. There we have it, reverse path direction, and there it is. And actually, we can also use the attributes panel, because in here we've got the same. So you can reverse the direction of these paths, and then you can fix that winding rule as well. Like so. And there you have it. You've got it working.